Hello everyone, this is Electro Steel here again with another video for you guys, and today I will be playing The Binding of Isaac. And if you do not know what The Binding of Isaac is, it is a Zelda-like and a roguelike all in one. So it plays like Zelda, like the earlier Zelda games, like the top-down view kind of thingy. And a roguelike means that it's randomized every single time. You get random items, random drops, random floors, enemies, everything. So yeah, let's go play this. So you have a couple of characters to choose from. I'm gonna pick Isaac because he's pretty balanced for speed, attack, and health. But you can unlock different stuff. So as you see in the top of my screen, you see my health in the form of those hearts. You see my spacebar item, of which I do not have one right now, but I will be picking up one, I hope. Then you see my tier effects. You shoot tiers in this game, and the window in that where the tier is in shows you what kind of tiers you have. And next to that is from top to bottom my money, my bombs, and my keys. And next to that is the map screen of all the rooms and what's in them, if I discovered them or not. And you can move it out like this, and you can shoot. Okay, so let's start. Funny thing is, this game is actually made by the same guy that made Super Meat Boy, so that kind of surprised me when I first read it. The guy from Super Meat Boy, Edmund McMillen, the guy from Super Meat Boy, made Binding of Isaac. I kind of was surprised, but when I started playing the Binding of Isaac, you could definitely see the level of polish that he brings to the table. I can't speak at all today. Oh my god. Okay, so this is a mini boss, and you want to. Whoa. Okay, I took no damage there, that's incredibly lucky. But the reason why I wanna stay. Whoa! That's the attack I wanted to avoid. Okay, so that's a run. Because it's randomized, you can get a mini boss in a room like this. Okay, so we picked up money and a tarot card. The High Priestess. I don't know what it does. I haven't played it for a while. I don't know what it does. Let's find some enemies and see what it does. Oh no, enemies here. An empty room. Okay. Oh, it brings down mom's food. Okay, now I know. Okay, that's good. At least these guys are not very difficult. Normally I have troubles with this floor. Okay, that's nice. Well, I can take this chest anyway. Blow up the rocks, take the chest. Oh, health that I can't use yet. Well, it's good in any case. Spiders, take them out real fast before they hop around to me. That's the thing about the cellar. You can in the expansion that I made, like the Wrath of the Lamp, you see the Wrath of the Lamp, you saw at the title screen of the game. They added normally you have a couple of floors, but they added extra versions of the floor and they make them more difficult. So if the first levels can be the basement or the cellar, and the cellar is harder than the basement because the cellar is spiders and spider enemies a lot. And there's two spider bosses that are really annoying to fight. So here's the item room, you can pick up a random item every time. Let's see, the mulligan, it's an attack fly. Every time I kill something or every time I get hit, I create an attack fly that will attack my enemies. At least that's what I think. Again, I have not played this game in a while. So this is the boss room. Let's go fight the boss. Oh, pain. This is not that difficult of a boss. It's no widow, so I can't really complain there. Again, every time you take an item, it changes your physical appearance. And because I take it in the Morrigan, you see my character model changed a bit. So that's really nice about this game. Every time, oh my god, I can't believe I took damage there. I feel so bad now. Yeah, so every time I get hit, I quit. Okay. I think it's all gone now. Yes, it's all gone. But it creates an attack fly every time I get hit. And the boss just bombed himself. So let me take a little bit of water. I'm sorry. Just to clean the throat. Because I need to beat the talking. Much better. Okay, so we killed the boss and we got an item from the boss and health. So let's pick up this health first. So what we got is the belt. And that is speed up. You can see in the bottom right corner, you can see what the item does when I pick it up. So let's go. Let's go on to the next floor. Please be basement. Ah, fuck. Cellar again. I hate cellar floors. Ah, man, these guys are annoying. Fuck! Because you need to avoid them, but they're not that easy to avoid. Because I shoot in all directions. I always have trouble with these guys, I don't know. I just suck at this game. Like, once again, Drexel still sucks at a video game, big deal. Oh, yes, nice. Okay, another tarot card. Strength, I think that gives us an extra attack power for the room. Let's check it out. Enemies. Yeah, I got hit there. That's what I mean, though, the spiders are really annoying. And now you start moving. Okay, that means we're going to go to. Okay, I'm gonna blow this up because there's a nickel behind it and it gives us 5 cents. Oh no, please don't. Can I blow these guys up? Can I blow them up before they explode? Come on, let's do it. Nice! Okay, that's the boss room. We don't want to go there yet because we have no item room yet. I want to pick up the item first. Oh my god. It hit me, really? Okay. Safety cap. I think that's the trinket that makes sure we got no bad pills. You can find pills in this game and they can be good, bad or nothing. So I think with this arm we don't get any bad pills. Okay, they all have to come through here, so. Leave me alone. Okay, so. Now we can bait this guy. Use a key to get into the item room. Lucky foot. I think that increases the chance of us getting item drops from rooms and chests and stuff. But it's no damage item, so I'm a bit... I don't like going to bosses without any damage. But who knows. At least I got full health, so... Ah, no! That's what I meant with the stupid spider boss. Okay. It must be done. Oh, this goes faster than I thought it would. But the thing that's so annoying about this boss is he creates spiders and spider spawners every single time. So nice. So we got a spirit heart, a soul heart, or the spirit heart. I don't know what they're called. But this is a temporary health. It will. I have that heart now, but when it goes away, I can't heal it back up again, so that's temporary. Here's my full health, and this is a health upgrade. Tears and HP up, so that means our fire rate is back. We have higher fire rate, we can fire more tears quickly. Let's go down again to the next floor. Okay. So there's a shop here, but it needs a key. So I'm gonna save that key for the item room. If I find another key, I will go to the shop to check out what I can buy there. Okay, this is the caves floor. You can see it in the bottom left corner. It is a floor with holes in it that you can't walk over, and new enemies. So two bombs. I don't have any bombs to get to the bombs. So. You always want to shoot out the fires, they can have pennies in them, or health, or spirit hearts. Two times in a row, the same room. That's weird. Yeah, I'm gonna get trapped in here so bad. It's not even... Oh my god, that was stupid damage though. Yeah, I know. Okay. A penny and a trap room. No, thank you. Let's go up. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna get behind him. Again, this is annoying because of the fucking flies and the thing I can't get over. Let's shoot the TNT. Because I can't move over them, it's so fucking annoying. Because the flies can fly over them, but I can't. Unless I pick up a flying item. Okay, let's go back because I want to find that item room first. Oh, bomb flies, that's nice. Not really, but still. Oh my god, that was stupid. Okay, next to the next room. Okay, so let's kill the normal one first before it. The thing is, they keep running away. They keep getting away from you, so you have to like go after them really hard. Okay, so that's this one is down. Now let's kill the champion one. The different color means it's like a champion version of the normal monster. And it drops extra items, so that's why. Okay, extra health, and the item room is here. Brother Bobby. It's another familiar. That's huge spectral tears that can go over the shit. Can get over the rocks. Like, see, my shots can... Wait, I have nothing to show it. Okay, let's go up again. But yeah, it is extra damage a little bit, so let's go. Oh, another nickel. But I have no keys for the shop. That's bad. Please give me a key. No key. Damn it! So I missed. I won't go to the shop this room. This floor, I mean. That's bad. That's a bummer because I don't have any keys for it. Okay, let's Let's go to the boss home again. Peep. Oh, that's quite annoying. It's doable, but quite annoying. So Peep jumps in the air and gives bullets when he lands. And at half, at half and three quarters of the health, he will send out the eyes, and those will damage you. They will just go across the room randomly, and they will damage you when one of them hits you. So okay, there we go. Come on. Oh my god, he hit me again. Okay, there goes the second eye. Oh no, I should have figured that he would jump my way. Oh my god, two eyes in this room is so annoying. Okay, I'm safe for the eyes now. Come on, die, Peep. Oh fuck, he landed on my face. Yeah, I suck at this game. I really, really suck at this game. So yeah, that was a little bit of The Binding of Isaac. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day, everybody. Have a nice day.